What's the next step?
Now we will be cutting a lemon. Well, I've already cut one. And these will be going in the pan later, and when they are cooked, they're easier to squeeze. So it makes, instead of just putting it on the side of the plate, I like to put it in the pan so that they're hot and just better to get all the juice out.
Looks like your mom splurged and bought seedless lemons.
Didn't even notice. Now I'm cutting out a piece of butter so that we can put it in the pan. And first we'll put in the olive oil. And we put in the butter. And we squeeze some lemon.
So because you're squeezing lemon, you should not use cast iron, correct?
Yes. Also, I don't like cast iron because you can't wash it with soap, which is kind of annoying. That's just my preference. So. It does it, I can see it. I need a spatula, so pause it, please.
Do you want to turn it down if it's too hot?
Yeah, can we?
Yeah. This is professional, dude.
Yeah. Cover, let's go through the salmon. With less of it.
You're going to salt and pepper it?
Oh, yeah. So now we're going to go with the salt.
Now we're going to
put the salmon in.
Oh, it doesn't sound hot enough.
Yeah, I forgot to
turn it. He accidentally turned it down. Oh, wrong one. That's the back one.
There we go.
There you go. You want to take it off till it gets hot?
That's okay.
Okay.
Should be fine.
Okay. Oh yeah, it's sizzling.
Yeah.
Ooh, that's a lot of pepper.
It'll be fine.
Okay.
Oh, there we go.
How long do we cook this for?
I don't have a certain time. I just normally wait till it looks like it's kind of crisp, not crispy, but like toasted on each side, and then flip it over. I check after like a minute. Well, it depends on how hot your stove is. This one I'll probably check sooner than others. Okay, so now we're gonna check. And this is kind of how I like it.
Okay.
So now we're gonna just... Oh, actually, no, I can go for a little bit.
Not enough yet. Okay, so flip it back over. There you go.
Okay, so now, after cooking for a little bit longer, they should be ready.
Yeah. Ooh, that looks good. A little crystallization there. Okay, now we wait for the other side.
Yep. Okay, and now we're gonna just see if we can squeeze the lemon a little bit and maybe put it on. Okay, so now we've gotten it and it looks
okay.
Like that.
Don't drop it.
We've already put the other two on. Yeah. And now we have that. And next we will be cooking the mahi tuna.
And putting some rice in there?
Yeah.
What are you doing now?
Now we're gonna go in with some of the tuna. Start sizzling pretty soon, hopefully.
I'll just hold the...
What?
I'll hold this here.
With these, we can do a few more at a time because they're smaller.
What kind of tuna is this?
It's mahi tuna for tacos. But we don't have taco shells. But we might make tacos with them later. We're just going in. We added some more oil and butter.
Can you get it on there? I think you could take a lemon out to get them in. There you go.
We season them the same way?
We as in?
Me.
Yeah.
It's an hour. I assume they're ready because they're cooked over. Oh yeah. Almost looks like chicken, a little bit. But I don't eat chickens. So. The lemons are in the way of this last one. There we go. Now, I'm gonna squeeze the lemons on top of them. So that was our video today, folks. And this is proof that even though mistakes happen, they can make very good food.